What's up, guys? So I wanted to show you my recent mail days. This is going to be a collection of my mail days for the past couple of weeks. So starting off, this is a 2018 National Treasures RPA of Ronald Acuna Jr. This is numbered out of 99 and it's in a BGS 9.5. I might just get this reslabbed with the subgrades. Personally, just my personal opinion, I think subgrades look better. There's some people that don't prefer it, but I prefer subgrades on any BGS slab. In the back of it, it has that 10 auto right here. So Cunha did pretty good this year. He did decent. He didn't exactly live up to what he had in the previous years. But I still have confidence in Ronald Acuna. You have that niche and you just believe in a player because of his consistency, his ability, his talent. If he can remain healthy for the next couple of years and be consistent with his numbers, then I truly believe he's going to be a star. He's already on a good team. They just need to get back into the World Series and for him to get his first ring, because from what I've read and everything, last year the Braves, you know, they won the World Series. However, the amount of games played for Ronald Acuna, I don't think that qualified him to actually earn a World Series ring. The reason that I know that is because when I look up his stats, when I look up his stats and his accolades, it doesn't include a World Series ring. So my only guess, and it's a pretty confident guess, is that he only played a limited amount of games, which prevented him from actually getting a World Series ring. So hopefully this year or maybe next season, they get into the World Series and he can put that officially on his accolades. Hope you guys like this card. On to the next one. My next pickup is a UFC card. It's going to be of this 2021 Select Disco Prism Signature of Jose Aldo. PSA 10 with the Auto 10. If you haven't heard, Jose Aldo, he recently announced his retirement, and UFC, they released him soon after that. He still had one fight on his contract, but he requested the release because of his retirement, so the UFC released him. Honestly, I don't think he's done fighting. He may be weighing his other options, but I believe eventually he's going to have that itch to come back either to the UFC or maybe to another organization, maybe Bellator or one of the other ones. But I started watching Jose Aldo in the beginning when he was the first UFC featherweight. He held that title. He defended that title numerous times. And then a person named Conor McGregor came along and beat him. But prior to that, he was unstoppable, unbeaten. And I personally think he's a legend within the UFC featherweight division.
Just kind of slipping those punches by Stevens. Right there, he went right body shot, left body shot. Jeremy could not hide the pain. Hey, it's that liver. It happened earlier, and what did we say? It shuts your body down. It does not matter what your mind is telling you. Your body shuts down.
Aldo, one of these men will probably get a shot at the champ, and right off the bat, it is over. It is absolutely over.
And so, will he make Hall of Fame? No doubt. I think, no doubt, Jose Aldo will make the Hall of Fame. So, this is a great card. It's not numbered. It should be, but I just like it because it's a pop one, PSA 10, auto 10. I mean, the most perfect grades you can get in PSA. So I will keep this for a while. This is more of a PC thing. So I hope you guys like that one. On to the next. So my next pickup is in the comic book world. I started collecting them a couple years ago. I remember getting the first appearance of Gambit comic book. And then I also had, I believe, a Scarecrow one. in the transition of moving, I lost both of those and I was really devastated, but trying to get back into it, trying to repurchase those items and as well as the other items. This one happens to be Hellblazer number one, not the first appearance of John Constantine, but the first cover of his own. So basically his solo version on the cover, you know, first time being on the cover for John Constantine. And if you guys haven't seen the movie, probably one of the greatest movies I think there is, and they just announced there's going to be a part two coming out soon, or it's going to be started soon, and Keanu Reeves, who starred in the first one, he's going to come back and help make the second one. But as soon as that was announced, I'm like, you know what, let's go on eBay, let's check out the market for this. And this comic book means a lot to me because as Constantine being one of my favorite movies, I also wanted the comic book itself. I believe Netflix came out with a series of John Constantine. It didn't live up to the movie, of course, because it's only a series. But this movie, this character, it just draws my attention. And I got it at 9.6. There was others for 9.8, but kind of out of my price range. But I'm starting to get back into these comic books. So there's the back cover. Here's a little quote by Alan Moore. But yeah, I love these comic books. Yeah, there we go. John Constantine, Hellblazer number one. And on to the next. All right, guys. So as you can see, I've been dabbling into everything. My next pickup was a Funko Pop pickup of the NWO.
Well, the first thing you gotta realize, brother, is this right here is the future of wrestling. You can call this the New World Order of Wrestling, brother.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
I have other Funko Pops of sports players, but this is my first wrestling Funko Pop. The NWO, I grew up watching them. They were the most badass faction. They changed wrestling, and for the ones that know, they were in constant battle with the WWF, aka the WWE. So they always had those Monday Night Wars with them. So you have right here, you have Hollywood Hogan, you have Scott Hall, the bad guy, and then you have Kevin Nash. So these were like the founding fathers of the NWO. They eventually got other members for the NWO, and then they actually made an NWO Wolfpack, but these were kind of like what you can say they were the founding fathers of the NWO. This is what this group right here, this trio started it all. So if you're a big wrestling fan, you know what I'm talking about. It was kind of like a childhood memory for me. I don't watch wrestling anymore, but the NWO was definitely a huge part of me growing up. And so I have NWO shirts. I have some socks. I would love to get this signed by either Hollywood Hogan or Kevin Nash. Rest in peace, Scott Hall. I wish I could get your signature, but I'll settle for the other two. But I think that would be cool, just to get signatures of Hollywood Hogan or Kevin Nash. That would be cool. But yeah, this is my Funko pop-up pickup. There's nothing much on the back. Just shows their names and shows the other wrestler Funko Pops that you can pick up. Stone Cold Steve Austin, China, Edge, Drew McIntyre, Otis. I really don't know those other two. I know the top three, but I don't know those other two. But yeah, here's the back of it, guys. So maybe I'm getting into Funko Pops. I don't collect these all the time, but when I do see something online, I really want to snatch it up. So I did buy this online. It says Walmart, but I doubt my Walmart even has it. So yeah, hope you guys liked it. And on to the eBay authentication reveal. What's up, guys? So I wanted to share with you this mail day that I got. It's mail day / eBay authentication program day, I guess. This is the second order that I got from the eBay authentication program. I ordered and purchased this item on September 13th, and today is September 20th, which I received it. So it was less than 10 days, not too bad. It might have been with the authenticator maybe 2-3 days before it got sent to me. So, but overall, from the day I ordered it, purchased it, from the day it shipped to the authenticator and the authenticator to myself, less than 10 days, which isn't too bad. So we'll go ahead and open this. We have to open the sides first. And if I don't recall, here we go. There's no one right way to open this. Just open it from the side. Okay. Get rid of that box. And then we finally got the authenticity guarantee. Your collection is now upgraded. Yeah. Authentic without a doubt. Boom. So this item is a 2020 Immaculate Collection Shadowbox Signatures of Justin Jefferson. It's numbered out of 99. BGS9 with a 10 auto. So let's go ahead and review this, the case itself. Let's just check for any cracks, anything that should not be there where, from the original posting. Looks pretty good from the front. And this is a actual on-card auto. At first, I thought it was a sticker, but it's actually an on-card auto. But yeah, this is a beautiful card. Let's check the back. I actually leave this sticker on. The first card that I went through the program was my 2008 Topps Chrome Gold Refractor of Matt Ryan in a PSA 10. I just left this sticker on there because, you know, it just goes to show you that it went through the program. It's already authenticated. There's no need to re-authenticate it again. But going back just to back, looking for any cracks. It looks pretty good. A little dusty, but other than that, this is it's a good card. And just talking about the player himself, Justin Jefferson, I think he is bound for stardom, if not already. And he's one of the prominent young wide receiver talents in the NFL. And I see him, if he keeps up the consistency, I see him breaking all of the records that Jerry Rice currently has. Now, some of you might be like, oh no, Jerry Rice's records will never be broken. Well, I'll tell you what. Records, have you ever heard of this? Records are meant to be broken. And I think if anybody in the league has a chance to break Jerry Rice's records, it'd be this guy. So I want to do a stash and trash with this card and another card. So stay tuned for the upcoming weeks. I've already got the idea for the other player. I just got to get the card. So once I receive that card, I'll do another Stash or Trash video for you guys. But that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you guys liked it. Hope you guys liked the mail day. And it's just something that I've been waiting on for like a week and a half now. But I finally got it, so I'm happy. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. And I will see you next time. Peace.